नमस्कार, कुछ कमल हिया वेलकमिंग यू ऑल ऑन माय चैनल प्रोफेसर टॉक। आई टुक ए मंथ लॉन्ग ब्रेक टू रिजॉल्व सम प्रोफेशनल एंड पर्सनल इश्यूज, बट नाउ आई एम बैक विथ न्यू एनर्जी, न्यू टॉपिक, न्यू रिसर्च वर्क टू एस्टैब्लिश ए न्यू डिस्कशन एज वेल एज अ न्यू डिवाइस फॉर बेटर ऑडियो। सो बिफोर आई स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक, आई जस्ट वांट टू से थैंक यू सो मच ऑल माय लॉयल सब्सक्राइबर फॉर हैविंग सच काइंड पेशेंस and having trust in me. So let's start. So today I want to discuss exact the same topic I left behind. Why no one is talking about the miracle drug ivermectin? Why WHO suggested not to use on the COVID patient? What are the reason? What are the evidences? Let's discuss about that. But before watching this video, you watch this one first, so you will have better understanding what is ivermectin and how it has impacted India, how it has saved India. Let's move to the topic. ICMR and DGHS in their guidelines suggested use of ivermectin. But after a few weeks, DGHS, the governing body, dropped the ivermectin from the guidelines, including doxycycline also. Why they did that? Because just after adding ivermectin in the guidelines, head of WHO India and Dr. Soumya Swaminathan had posted this tweet. Safety and efficacy are important when using any drug for the new indication. WHO recommend against the use of ivermectin. Strictly, Soumya Swaminathan posted and informed the government of India about the WHO opinion about ivermectin. WHO recommend against the use of ivermectin. Only and only WHO suggested use of ivermectin for the clinical trial, not on the patients. But on global perspective, CDC, Center for Disease Control and Prevention, and World Health Organization, WHO, both recommended not to use ivermectin on the COVID patient. Even ivermectin was showing amazing positive result on COVID. Why they went against it? Let's find out. So after CDC and WHO, Gavi also, Gavi founded by Bill Gates, Gavi also made a report about why a potential COVID treatment isn't recommended for the use. So against the ivermectin, Gavi also published in WHO analysis. I have highlighted few points, including team of Dr. Kori, which I mentioned in previous video. Team of Dr. Kori has presented 60 different reports, the impact of ivermectin, in which WHO only included 16, rejected all. Even 13 prophylaxis stage trial, they rejected it. They excluded all epidemiological evidence, although WHO has considered such evidence in the past. So it means in previous different kind of analysis, epidemiological evidences WHO used to consider, but for particular this case, they excluded it, just like they excluded prophylaxis studies also. As in the report already mentioned that ivermectin work in early stage and prophylaxis stage. But what WHO did to show the inefficiency of ivermectin, what they did, they included early and late treatment study both. But ivermectin only work in early stage. Then why they added late treatment study also? Just to drop the efficiency of ivermectin against COVID virus. In their analysis, there are few detailed points also I'm presenting here. If you want to read, you will find all the research paper in descriptions. You can read if you have time. If I'm talking about a summary, although WHO analysis predict that over 2 million fewer people would be dead if ivermectin was used from early in the pandemic, WHO knew already. If they allowed ivermectin to use in the early stage, 2 million people would be alive right now. Even knowing the fact, they recommended against the use of outside trial. Something really, really scary here. Something really, really shady here. If you look at the other point, another point, so two things very shady here. One, recommendation of WHO, even knowing that ivermectin is a very successful drug. On other hand, even after recommendation from the discoverer of ivermectin, the company which produced ivermectin at the first place denied the clinical trial of it. WHO Chief of India, Dr. Soumya Swaminathan, when she tweeted about the stand of WHO over ivermectin, she recommended everybody to take a look at the report of Merck. Before jumping on the report of Merck, first, know brief history of the ivermectin. Dr. Satoshi Amura of Japan discovered that one specific compound of bacteria culture, a streptomycin bacteria culture, has capability to kill the roundworm in the mice. Then he sent the report to the Dr. William Campbell. At that time, he was scientist of Merck, pharmaceutical company Merck. And Dr. William Campbell extract that particular compound from the streptomycin bacteria. and discovered ivermectin. And that ivermectin, you can say, saved Africa from the disease called river blindness. In 2015, ivermectin received Nobel Prize. Both doctor received Nobel Prize, Satish Omura and Dr. William Campbell. Because Dr. William Campbell was scientist of Merck, Merck got the patent. Merck produced 3.7 billion doses. And according to report of Merck, ivermectin is safer than even paracetamol. That's safe, that drug is. Because ivermectin got produced by Merck, and before 1996, the patent of ivermectin was under Merck. So that's why Soumya Swaminathan posted report of Merck on ivermectin. Let's look at the report. Merck has mentioned 3 points in which no scientific basis of potential therapeutic effect against COVID from pre-clinical studies. Merck completely denied the impact of ivermectin on COVID virus. No meaningful evidence for clinical activities or clinical efficiency in patient with COVID-19 disease. Like if anybody taking ivermectin as antiviral drug, there is no meaningful evidence or clinical efficiency of ivermectin. And third point, a concerning lack of safety data in majority of studies. Merck rejected all 60 data on the basis of safety measures. So these three only points they raised. But the question is, why Merck completely reject the impact of ivermectin? So let's look at the conflict of interest of Merck. Merck has committed to give ivermectin away for free, as much as possible, as long as possible. But they realized in 1996 when they lost the patent, their 100% control of the market of ivermectin dropped to just 5%. Because after getting patent free, anybody was making. In India, you can find in 93 rupees. You can say just more than dollar, you can get 10 pills, 10 tablet. So the grab of market, the profitable market, they lost after losing the patent in 1996. Second point, ki Merck has their own new COVID-19 treatment, MK-7110. For COVID, Merck was working on new type of medicine, new type of vaccine. If they would have suggested ivermectin is successful on COVID, then why people gonna buy MK-7110? And on other hand, they were working on another drug, another antiviral drug, molnupiravir. So they were working on two new drug. They were looking for profit. Why would they recommend? It would be a loss for them. So it means promoting the use of low off-patent medicines compared to new product MK-7110 and molnupiravir may be undesirable to some shareholders. A third conflict of interest is Japan requested Merck to conduct a clinical trial early in the pandemic and they declined. If you're gonna look at the broad picture, WHO not only denied the use of ivermectin, rejected the idea of using ivermectin, but also recommended not to use the other medicines. And primary one is hydroxychloroquine, SCQ, ivermectin, remdesivir. India was going crazy for the remdesivir. But if you look at the data, WHO issued a conditional recommendation only against the use of remdesivir in hospital patients regardless of disease severity. And there is no scientific evidence it improves survival or other outcome. So they don't reject it directly, but they are not also favoring it. They also rejected tolizumab and corticosteroid also. Then here the biggest question is, why CDC, WHO, Gavi, Merck all rejected the use of ivermectin and other antiviral drugs against COVID? Why they rejected? And there is only one reason is, and the sale of vaccine depend on the size of fear, as much as pharmaceuticals gonna make the profit from the vaccine. In the next topic, I will discuss about why we constantly reading about the benefit of vaccines, but we are not reading about other thing, the other perspective, the story of other side. I'm going to explore more. I'm going to research more, try to bring out the truth. Why all the content everywhere on internet getting censored if content is based on ivermectin? Even this video going to be censored, even this video going to be deleted. I can't say anything. Who is doing that? Why is doing that? Who is getting profited of that? We will discuss above all in the next videos. Thank you so much for your patience. If you like this video, subscribe, support. Please help me to get 1,000 subscribers. Spread the word, spread the knowledge. Take care of yourself. Thank you. Jai Hind.